And welcome to this video in See the Light, Easy Wins to Improve Your Asset Framework Experience. In the previous video, we went through just the introduction to this lab and the environment we're going to be working with. We saw that we're working with a packaging company called Sweet and Savory Corp. And the main asset of interest for us is a form, fill and seal machine. We left off where we decided that you were the PI system administrator. And you've been doing a little bit of work in AF and PyVision, and you've made the brave decision to chat to one of the engineers and ask for feedback on your work and the displays that you've built. Now, when you want to see how a system operates in day-to-day use, PI System Explorer is really not the best place for that. It can tell us a lot of information, but it's not a program that you're going to be using on a daily basis as a user. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and open up PyVision. Now I've got PyVision preloaded on my side. On your side there's a desktop shortcut. It's just called PyVision. And the reason I've preloaded is that when you start up PyVision for the first time on a computer, it can sometimes take a little while because there's a fair amount of caching that takes place. So if it is taking a little bit of time for you, don't worry too much. You'll notice as we go through the lab that when you open it up next time, it's really quick. It just has to do that initial sort of load up once. So to start looking at when we start looking at the system, you've got the engineer sitting down with you. And effectively what we're going to do is we're going to go through the system, find a couple of issues, jot them down on a piece of paper if you want to, and then we're going to go ahead and later on apply some best practices. So, engineer sitting with you, and you decide, okay, well, the place that we're starting is Sandbox Overview FFS. So, we're going to go ahead, open up that display. And this is just a nice overview of the assets that we're working with. We've got a breakdown of your form, fill, and seal machine with bags today in the OEE. You can see a couple of calc fails and things like that around here. Don't worry too much about that. On the bottom left, we've got a table. That just shows us the asset, its model, availability, monthly average, and packing rate status. Now, the reason those have got no data is because we don't have enough good data to perform the calculation. These virtual machines get shut down and only powered on for training purposes. And for that reason, we don't have a full month worth of data. We've also got a little bit of sugar information with grain size. And some stats about that standard deviation, minimum, maximum, what have you. If you want to look at a little bit more detail, so let's say I want to see more information about FFS01, what I can do is just go and click there. Just hovering shows that there's a link to the display called Sandbox FFS Monitoring. A single click there will navigate me to a separate display, and this has got a little bit more information. So what we can see here is FFS01 is packaging salt. It's got a packaging rate per minute at the moment of 0 bags per minute, so it's having some downtime at the moment. But we can see that when it's operational, it hovers around 60. We've got a sealer temperature and a moisture content display. And bottom left, we've got a little bit of information about the device, its model, its nominal max throughput, who the operator is, what the packaging rate is, and which shift we are currently in. And then we've got some information about how many bags have been done today, what the current throughput efficiency and OEE are. So this is a nice detailed display. Something like this, when you're familiar with PyVision, takes 2 or 3 minutes to build. One of the benefits of using PyVision in conjunction with Asset Framework is it gives us the ability to switch assets. So you've already read a little bit about templates. Basically what we've got going here is I have the ability to switch between any form, fill and seal machine, provided they are based on an accurate template. So if I want, I can go and look at device number 3. And all the static information, the layout of the display stays static, but the information displayed there is updated. So just cycling through here, I've got FFS04. And then the engineer taps you on the shoulder and says, listen, form, fill and seal machine number 5 has been giving us issues, where is it? And you're not entirely sure, So the first issue we're gonna have is that when switching between our assets, I can go to six, I can go to four, but form fill and seal machine number five is not available to me. So that's our first issue. The engineer's now, he's found an error, so he's excited, he wants to keep going. So he says, click back to the overview for me so I can have a bit of a deeper dive into the data here. And we don't normally work with a full day worth of data at a time. I want to see maybe the last hour. So the engineer says, can you change to the last hour? And that's done simply through this selection box at the bottom. We have a couple of predetermined timestamps, which are the most common. If you want to work with a timestamp that's not indicated over here, you can go ahead and change your start and end time, and that will allow you to put a custom time range for the display. We're just going to select 1 hour. And he has a look and he looks at the display because that's where most of the trend's updated. And the engineer points out and says, listen, form fill and seal machines number three, four, and six, they're actually different machines. They'll have their own values, they'll have their own issues. And at the moment, it looks like they're all displaying exactly the same data. If you hover over the trend, I can see that I'm looking at form fill and seal machine number three, the sugar grain size. And if I go to number six, I've got form fill and seal machine number six with the sugar grain size. So that tells me it's not a problem in the way the display's been built. It's more an issue on maybe something in AF that we'll have to look at. So that's your second issue jotted down. We've got a problem with identical data going to multiple assets. So engineer has a look here, can't see any more issues. He's happy he can see the units of measure on display, and that makes him start thinking about the more detailed reports where we've got trends and things like that going. So he just asks you to switch back to that detailed display with form fill and seal number one. So we'll click through and navigate, and the engineer he starts rubbing his hands and says, hey, listen, the sealer temperature. Minus 17, so it's not running at the moment. We can't really trust that value. But if we have a look at when it's normally operating, it looks like it's got a value of what's at 57. That's not right. Most of the time, this device, it needs to melt plastic in order to sever the bags and seal them. So we know that the minimum temperature is going to be 70 Fahrenheit, and it goes up to 270 Fahrenheit during peak operation. So there's a problem here where 57 in Celsius might be about the right temperature for a low operating temp, but it's definitely not 57 Fahrenheit. It's like a cold glass of water. I assume, I'm not sure on what Fahrenheit, how the scale works. So, engineer's happy that he's got the third issue, and then he starts looking around the display a little bit more. And realizes, hang on, this display is not only going to be used by us, the maintenance guys are going to have access to it as well. And something the maintenance guys are always really excited for are service dates. So when is the last time that device number three was serviced? And he assumes you have that information because it's sitting along with your sort of what the model of the machine is and what its nominal max throughput, all of that comes from the same system. So he wants to know if you can just pop the last time the machine was serviced. Luckily for you, you've actually got that information already created in the AF database, and that's linked through a table to the asset maintenance system. So it's a simple matter of dragging and dropping it onto the display. In order to do that, you decide to do it there and then for him, and you go into edit mode. And you start looking for your assets. So we expand Sweet and Savory Corp, Sandbox, and Packaging. At the moment, we are working with asset FFS03. So what we want to do is make sure that FFS03 is selected there. And in order to see the last service date, he just asks you to drop it in that table. We'll sort of do a click and a drag and just drop it off there. And the engineer's not too worried. You've started thinking, hang on, this is taking a long time. So if you've done this, don't stress, just do it the once. This is a potential indicator of a slow table lookup in the background because it's not able to resolve when you load it up into the table. So we can see here FFS03, it took a couple of seconds, but the last service date is was the 1st of Jan 2018 at midnight. That is highly unlikely, but we'll go with it. So that's the last time this machine was serviced, and we can go ahead, check unit number one, and it updates. He's happy, but in the back of your mind, you're thinking, I've added assets before, I've added attributes to tables. It doesn't normally take that long. Maybe that's something I should just jot down for myself. It takes a long time to update that display. So we've got the four issues now. We'll go ahead and just exit this edit mode. And clicking save will just lock that change in and make sure that the last service date is available. Cool. He wants to just make sure that all of your assets are working now. So starting to cycle through, you've got FFS01. It looks healthy enough. FFS02. Okay, the machine's down. FFS03. What have we got going? We can see it's got a model and a nominal max throughput. Temperature's looking good. It's packaging nicely. Number four. And there's an issue here. The nominal max throughput is telling us no data. Now, that doesn't make sense to you because you know that FFS01 is a MF Techno asset. That's what determines what the nominal max throughput is. So, and it's only FFS04. So there's a problem here where number six works. See MF Techno, it's got a max throughput of 70. So just jot down that the fifth issue we've got is that FFS04 has no max throughput, nominal max throughput that we're aware of. He's happy he's found five issues. So you go ahead and you just click on home, and you want to start showing off a little bit and how you've started organizing displays into folders and things like that. And he sees the word faulty on the display. Now, faulty is something, it's a great way to name a display when you're working on it and it's secret and you want to just make sure that stuff's working and you know where you stand. But the engineer is now assuming everything's working and it's ready to go and start playing with data. So he says, just click there for me. He grabs the mouse out of your hand and clicks on sandbox FFS faulty title. And he says it doesn't look too bad. I mean, it looks fine. And you say, no, the problem is when I switch from one to two, apparently I'm still form fill and seal machine number four doing some sugar packaging, and the rest of the display is showing us for device two or device three. So that's the problem. This is when I was learning how the titles work, and engineer's interested. He wants to know, hang on, can we make that update automatically? So say, of course we can. When we start going, when I've fixed all the issues, what I can do is I can call you back into my office and show you when you start building your own displays. We'll show you how to make it so that the titles update and all the fancy things happen. So just to recap some of the issues from your meeting with the engineer. If we go in the order we started with, in our overview FFS monitoring display, when we navigate to form fill and seal machine number one, our first issue we found is that there was a problem viewing data for form fill and seal machine number five. So that's the first issue we're going to have to check up on. The second issue we're going to have to check up on is that on the overview display, we had a problem where, when looking at only 1 hour of data, form, fill, and seal machines 3, 4, and 6 had identical tags feeding the data, so that's something we're going to have to look at. The third issue we found was in the detailed display of form, fill, and seal machine number 1, where the sealer temperature was way out of range when it should, in standard operation, be between 70 and 270. It's currently sitting at 60 under normal operation, so that's not good. Our fourth issue was that adding the last service date to the display that caused a real slowdown in Power Vision. And while the engineer's happy he can see it, you know that if something takes that long to add to the display, when the display updates and refreshes over time, that's going to cause constant delay, which will be annoying to work with. Our fifth issue was that form, fill, and seal machine number 4 had no data feeding it for the nominal max throughput. So we need to sort that out. Even though when we look at unit number 6, we did have a throughput and they are the same model type, which is MF Techno. And then our sixth issue was that we've managed to fix it in the past, but the engineer wants to know how to fix this faulty title display. So we're going to go ahead and fix this display towards the end of our troubleshooting process. The next lesson is just going to be we'll start off with a recap of the issues that we found, and then what we're going to do is break it down into 6 individual videos, and each of those videos will pinpoint the issue. We'll do some fault finding to find out what the issue is, and then we will apply best practices to fix that issue and hopefully show you some improvements in performance or ease of use by applying those best practices.